अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर सेफ एंड साउंड एंड ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टेइंग एट होम टू कीप योरसेल्फ सेफ फ्रॉम कोविड-19। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास प्रोग्राम ऑफ बाईशे सेकेंडरी स्कूल। This is Muhammad Abdul Malik, assistant teacher, English of this school. Dear students, in the previous class I taught you present perfect tense. Now I am going to teach you past perfect tense. So dear students, take precaution to write the important things. Please take your exercise book and pen so that you can write. Look at the board, please. Past perfect tense, past perfect tense. Dear students, at first read a sentence. I am going to write a sentence and read it. Rana had taken breakfast before Runa came here. Dear students, another sentence. Email went to market after his father had gone to his office. Dear students, read the sentences and try to guess what I have written. Try to understand. In the first sentence, there are two actions. The first action is Rana's taking breakfast, and the next action is Runa's coming here. There is a word before. In present perfect tense, we used have, but here we have used had. So, dear students, this is a difference from present perfect tense and past perfect tense. And another difference, we did not use before or after in present perfect tense. And in present perfect tense, we used only one action. But there is another action. And from this part, we come to know that this part is past indefinite. Past indefinite tense. And this part is past perfect tense. Past perfect tense. Dear students, there is a formation of past perfect tense: subject, then had, then the past participle of the main verb, then other words. And similarly, in this sentence, we also see past perfect tense. His father, this part is subject, had is auxiliary verb, gone the main verbs, past participle form. And this part is in the past indefinite tense. Past indefinite tense. From these two sentences, we can say that if we use before, then the past perfect tense will be written at first. And the other part would be written in the past indefinite tense. But the case is different when we will use after. If we use after, the past perfect part would be written after. That means at the end of the sentence. And the past indefinite part would be written at first. That means in the beginning of the sentence. And if you translate any Bengali sentence into English, then you will write the last part at first and the first part at last. And try to remember that if there are two actions in the sentence, you will separate the actions at first, which action would be taken place at first. The actions which will be taken place at first, that action would be formed in past perfect tense, and the other actions would be formed in past indefinite tense. So dear students, in this way we can learn past perfect tense. And if you want to know the structure separately, I will tell you in forming the past perfect tense. First of all, you will use subject, then head, then the first participle form of the main verb, then other words, then you can use before, then past indefinite tense. And in another way, at first you can set past indefinite tense, then after, then past perfect tense. Write the examples and identify the parts. Dear students, I think all of you have written and all of you have understood past perfect tense. There is another part in past perfect tense. I would teach you that part after completing it. So I don't want to mix that part with this part. So dear students, no more today. Next day I would teach the another part of past perfect tense. In that part we would learn the use of nosuna, then hardly, had when, and scarcely had when. And we would also learn the use of since. When we would since, we would use since in past perfect and past indefinite tense. It will be taught in the next class. So don't forget to attend my next class. And dear students, please share this online class in your YouTube channel and Facebook account so that all other students can learn it. Dear students, I thank you from the core of my heart for attending my today's class and trying to understand my lecture. If you find any question, you will throw the question in the comment box. I am always ready to answer to your question. Thank you all. Remain safe from COVID-19. Stay at home. Thank you.